Hello everyone! Today I would like to show you how to use the popular video game Minecraft as an FPV drone flight simulator. Step number one is to ask your kids for their Minecraft username and password. Hey, what's your Minecraft username and password? Step number two is to install Minecraft. So if you don't already have Minecraft on your computer, you can head on over to minecraft.net, download the version for your computer, and you'll want the Java version because that's the one that uses this mod. Step number three is to download CurseForge, which is a program that makes it a lot easier to install mods like the FPV Flight Simulator mod into Minecraft. You can go to download.curseforge.com to grab the latest version, download it for your operating system. Step number four is to create a profile in CurseForge using Minecraft version 1.16.5, which is the latest version you can use with the FPV mod. Okay, now it's time to fire up CurseForge, and if you have Minecraft properly installed on your computer, it should automatically find it here, and it'll show it to you over here on the left. And what you need to do now is create a custom profile, and I'm gonna put in 507RC, oops, here, and I need to pick Minecraft version 1.65 because that's the latest version that the mod currently works with. Click create, and now you've got a profile ready to go to add a mod to. So we move on to the next step. Step number five is to search for the FPV mod. All right, so I'm going to click on this little picture here, and I don't want to play it yet because I don't have the mod yet. I want to add more content, and then I'm going to search for mods. I'm going to search for FPV. And the only thing that should show up is this Minecraft FPV mod. And we're going to click install. And now it's installed. That's all there is to it. Step number six is to launch the game. We'll go back here and now I can click play to launch the game. And again over here, make sure we're running Minecraft Java version. Click play. It's got the mod installed. Step number seven is to grab a drone remote controller like this one, connect it to your computer, and calibrate it in the game. You want to turn it on. Then you want to plug it into your computer. And hopefully your computer will recognize that it's been plugged in. And we want to go over to click on the options. And we're going to click on controls. And now because of this mod, we've got this new button up here called FPV. And I can click FPV. I'm a new pilot. Yes, I have a controller. It detected mine. My DJI FPV remote happens to show up as a C5 for some reason. I'm going to choose that. Center the sticks. Proceed. Move my left stick up, and it's going to auto-detect it. Center the sticks again. Proceed. Move my left stick to the right. Proceed. Right stick up. Proceed. Right stick to the right. Proceed. Move my sticks around. Make sure it detects everything. And now I can see that if I move my sticks up, down, left, right, yep, those boxes are matching my movements, so I can proceed. And now it's asking which button I want to use to like flip into drone flying mode. And for some reason, none of the buttons on this DJI radio are picked up by the computer. So I'm just going to have to move one of the sticks and pretend that that worked and say proceed. Now I want to go back into more settings and channel mapping and change that arm switch back to normal. Just otherwise it won't work right with this remote. Hopefully you won't have to do that if you're using a different remote. You can actually flip a switch and it'll detect it for you properly. I'm gonna say done, done, done. And now we can move on to the next step. Step number eight, fly. All right, I'm gonna go to single player, create a new world. Oh, where the heck am I? Like right inside a tree or something? All right, I need to do WASD for a little bit here and make that go away. And look around, yeah. Okay, now if I hit I, I'll flip into FPV mode and I can start trying to fly around. Now this, how fun this is really depends on, on your level, what it automatically generated, or if you've loaded a level where you've already been playing, you can fly around and stuff. Ooh, I could dive way down into a mine there. If I was good enough, I don't want to get in there. Let's see, what's over this way? So at first thing I notice is that it feels really floaty, or like the scale and gravity are off a little bit, but it does let you fly around, you get used to the controls, and you can change a lot of different settings. You can pretend to fly a small drone, a big drone, you can change the power of the motors, all sorts of things in the options. I definitely encourage everyone to go play around with that. You should also go check out their website where they show you how to connect to their server. On their FPV server, they have some race tracks set up that will automatically time you. You can create your own tracks, you can have races and leaderboards, and all kinds of cool stuff. Ooh, I'm up there a little too high. Definitely over the 400 foot legal limit in most parts of the world, right? Whoa. Ooh, that looks like a cool little spot to climb or dive down into. Oh, but there's no way to get out. Anyway. Okay, hit escape, get back to the menu. You go into the options and under controls and back to the FPV section again. You can see here at the top, I can choose whether I'm flying a 5-inch drone or a tiny whoop. The tiny whoop actually feels a little more realistic to me for some reason. And there's other settings you can choose if you want 3D mode where you can like fly upside down, what you want, your lenses and your field of view, all kinds of good stuff there. But the defaults are not bad at all. If you're looking for even more information, go check out the FPV Mod's website where they have a link to their wiki, they have a link to their Discord server, and they've got some YouTube videos that show you all the cool things you can do in this mod. And that's all it takes to use Minecraft as a FPV drone flight simulator. Oh, here's a cave I can fly through. Nice.